I'm all about business. Somewhere in the trenches, moving weight, I'm on my 24-hour fitness. I don't need a witness, moving with the quickness. Was off the porch when you was on them playground benches. Block bleeding, smoking trees, eyes Chinese. High speed, singing every lick, walking by me. I'm sticking to the cold like a Siamese. Twin Glocks on me, shoot them up like some
ID. What up, world? What up, Fight Fam? It's your boy, Mac. Stay Ready Boxing TV, giving you some news you can use. Say, dig these blues. It was a lot going on in the world of boxing. Hey, today it was a lot going on in the world of boxing. HBO getting out the fight game. Billy Joe Saunders popping dirty or did it? Tyson Fury talking shit. Devon Haney getting ready to fight Burgos. George Groves and Campbell boxing tomorrow. We got a lot going on. And we'll make this short and sweet little video, you know, coming at you with what's going on in the world of boxing, man. We're going to start off with HBO leaving the game after 45 years, man. And as my boy Fanon say, good riddance to bad rubbish. Hey, I used to look forward to watching, when I was younger, I used to look forward to watching boxing on HBO, Showtime, Tuesday night fights on ESPN, Thursday night fights on Fox, you know. I used to look forward to all this stuff. Man, I got to cut a nick in my damn mustache. Oh, well. Yeah. Man, I used to look forward to it. But, man, more recently, lately, I hear so much bias coming out the mouths of people like Earl Letterman and Jim Lampley, man. And even Max and Roy, who, well, Roy, you supposed to, you know better. That's all I'm going to say, you know better. I hear so much bias come out of your mouth, especially when it comes to people like Wilder. Deontay Wilder, and really the same thing for Max, but Max works for ESPN, so he's going to push his narrative. He's going to help ESPN push their narrative, like building up fighters. You know, Lomachenko, Triple G, you know, y'all still building these guys up, but what about the fighters instead of putting in work? Mikey Garcia, Terrence Crawford, you know, you got people like that. That's another video for another day. We gonna keep talking about this, but you got people like Harold Letterman and Jim Lampley there. In that fight with Triple G and Camilla, key example. Jim Letterman said Triple G dominated. Work. I didn't see it nowhere. If you go back and watch that fight right now without the commentator, you'll see what I'm talking about. It's frustrating, even hearing the simple come out their mouth. Harold Letterman, looking at his scorecard. How the fuck do you score a lot of those rounds, man? I'm sitting there looking at the rounds, and I'm like, how the fuck you get that round at Triple G? Canelo clearly won that round. Clearly. The first four rounds, I know Canelo won. He had Canelo winning two. I don't see. That's beside me. It's bias, man. And I think all the bias has commentating is the reason y'all lost so much viewership. You had casual fans that know the sport of boxing, they knew you in line. Then you got fanatics like us that knows how the judges score the fight, what I'm looking at, and you clearly lying to the public. Don't nobody want to see that. We want to see a good fighter. We want to sit here entertaining commentator. Like Paulie Malignaggi. I like the way Paulie. He buys sometimes too, but at least he makes the fight. He don't like cheaters, and I understand that. But when he commentates a fight, he makes it sound pretty good. And I can listen to that. You know. Now, I want to talk about Billy Joe Saunders. When I first got the news that he got popped for drugs, I was really upset. Like, I was upset because I'm tired of cheaters in the sport of boxing, man, because you're taking advantage and you going out here into the ring and you got somebody else's life in your hands. You getting the advantage with these drugs. That shit right there, man, that's some whole-ass shit. And I'm just going to say it just like that. I don't give a damn. That shit right there is bullshit. This shit is bullshit. I looked up what Xylophone is. I used to look it up. Now, it's used as blood pressure medicine. It's also used with amphetamine. But the big thing about oxyntophrine is that they use it in nasal spray as well, which is true. I saw that. In Australia, they use it as nasal spray. It's not, the FDA haven't approved it for use in America. That's what Tyson Gay got busted using. That's what Asafa Powell got caught up with. You know, if y'all don't know who them are, though, I like track and field. Those are track and field guys. You know, Tyson Gay is an American track and field. You know, 100, 200 meter dash. Asafa Powell is Jamaican. You know, he's one of the six Jamaicans that got caught. And the body tested for the Olympics. But yeah, it's what they got caught in. So when I first heard it, I actually was kind of frustrated. And then later it came out that he passed the United Kingdom drug, you know, administrator, whatever. He passed that. And they said it was nasal spray. So we're gonna see what the investigation come out. I'm not gonna jump to conclusions right now, but I will say this, if you find out that you really were doping, man, really frustrates me. But we're gonna see. Because it's also used as a fat burner too. So we're gonna see how much is in the system. But they can't test for that. They start asking for more blood tests and hair samples and shit like that. And you know, when you fail all of it, a large amount, then we know you're not. But you just got, you know, they tracing up, might be nasal spray, might be suffering from allergies and sinuses. But let's move on to another next topic, Tyson Fury. Going back to talking shit like he always do. He told Deontay Wilder in the video today that he's gonna knock him out. He can't handle a boxer like him. So we're gonna see. I'm ready. December 1st, LA, Staples Center, man. Get a stacked undercard. I'm gonna talk about that tomorrow. My Friday video, you know, I'm gonna make it interesting. You know, talk about all these fights coming up in this undercard. I heard this one. Oh my God. I really wanna do that. And I heard this one. Monster undercard. I'm ready to see what's going down. Devon Haney and Burgos. What round you gonna knock him out in, champ? Because he's going to be a future champion. I'm calling him champ because he's going to be a future champion. I like that boy Devon Haney. He's no longer a prospect in my eyes. He's a solid fighter, a solid boxer. I believe he's going to be a champ. Especially in the division of the game. Hey, it's coming. Y'all watch out. They need to go and put that boy in the ring with some more with some of these top boxers. I think he's ready for these top fighters. This Burgos gonna be easy. Man. Don't believe me? Watch it tomorrow. George Groves Campbell, great fight. We might talk about you more tomorrow too. Need to look at some more game film. Break it down. Yeah, that's what I like to do. I like to break down fights, and see how they style so much. That's my favorite thing to do. Break down their style, analyze the fight, and go from there. That's it. Y'all leave y'all comments. Let me know what y'all think. You know, what y'all think about Billy Joe Saunders getting popped. Let me know what y'all think about HBO getting rid of boxing. Let me know what y'all think about my videos and how I've been doing lately. You know, just leave your comments. Like, subscribe if you ain't subscribed already. Like my videos, it helped with the visibility of my videos, man. And hit that bell icon so you can stay updated on my new latest content. Shout out to the whole LDBC. Say that again. Shout out to the whole LDBC. This your boy Mac. Stay ready, Boston TV, man. You ain't gotta get ready if you stay ready. One love.